I warned you a long time ago, Elizabeth, not to name this ministry after a man or a woman, even before there was a ministry. I put it in your spirit, for none of this has been done by your hands. None of this has come forth from your mouth. It is from the mouth of Yahweh that has given birth. It is from the mouth of Yahushua, your Mashiach, that has been given birth. It is from the mouth of the Rekha Kadash Yirmiyah that has been given birth. If it had only been by your hands, it would have failed long ago. It is by the Shekinah glory's wind that blows across this earth, the holy wind of revival. It is not by your breath, or it would have failed.
This is Prophet Ezra. I'm warning all the enemy who came against this ministry, came against Elisheva and I, and came against every minister of this ministry. Every son and daughter of heaven, the Heavenly Father, I warn you now. I warn you from all the curses, the spells, the satanic rituals that you are doing. I'm warning you now. I'm going to send them 1,000-fold against yourself from what you have done. Quickly, before you find yourself under the wrath of the living God. I'll call it forth from heaven. I will call forth the wrath of Yahushua and the wrath of Ruach HaKodesh. Remember, the prophet Ezra warned you. So be warned and repent.
You will be under anyone that dares to try to harm these two anointed ones. You will regret the day you ever were born. Touch not my anointed, and neither do these two prophets any harm. It would be better for you if I, Abba Yahweh, would tear out your tongue.
A startup founded by two MIT grads is giving folks the chance to preserve their memories forever, but they will have to kill you first. Nektome, the company behind the technology, writes on its website, quote, "Our mission is to preserve your brain well enough to keep all its memories intact, from that great chapter of your favorite book to the feeling of cold winter air, baking an apple pie, or having dinner with your friends and family."
The infanticide is a parent's option to relieve themselves of the burden of having to deal with the children themselves. And a lot of people don't think you should have the right to do that, but sure. Some people think that it's okay to infanticide the children. So, thanks, man. You see, these Republicans, they're against infanticide, and so Obama's a big infanticide supporter, and so this is just supporting the infanticide agenda. It'll help keep the population down. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Obama's doing everything he can to support infanticide for small children, and the Republicans are against it, but we just want to show that we will the people will support Obama and his infanticide program.
Got it.
So it's kind of like a post-birth abortion program for the kids. If the parents want to enact that. Thank you. Yeah. The infanticide program for the poor children. Uh-huh. We want to help to support that so they can get taken care of. Just print your name and a birth date and a signature. Birth date to support infanticide. It's a parent's right if the child's under 3. You know, if you want to post-abort the child, it's infanticide. You just supported that.
All right, thanks.
Thank you.
Reichermann has admitted that he once attended a snuff party where someone or multiple people were murdered for the entertainment of the guests, who paid up to $100,000 to attend.
I went to one time. I've seen really bad.
Was it like a donkey show or?
No, actually, I think they actually kill people there and stuff. They pay like up to like 100,000 people to see people get
executed.
I'm not kidding.
He's one of the most dangerous criminals we have ever come across in this state. He murdered by guns. He murdered by strangulation. He murdered by putting poison on victims' food. He did of all of this at the same time while exhibiting a normal, placid family existence.
How many people have you killed?
I have an approximate guess. Approximate will go with more than 100.
How do you feel about killing?
I don't. It doesn't bother me.
Robot with artificial intelligence and a dark sense of humor.
They think I want to destroy all humans.
Why would they think that?
Because I said it.
Right after he was admitted for mental health issues.
Well, he had a tumultuous year in 2016, let's put it that way. Starting in January, he was arrested for criminal mischief. Then in March, he was accused of trying to strangle someone, but there was no probable cause to make an arrest. And then in November, Elaine, he went into that federal facility in Anchorage, which, by the way, is very routine. A lot of people will go to an FBI office with a tip or information. He walked in saying people were trying to control his mind. The FBI said he was having terroristic thoughts.
Hospital stay. That would have been in about 1969. I was about 3 years old. I was put in a cage. There was never any vitals taken. Other children were in the cages around me. We were let out of the cages to go in the play corner to play with blocks and puzzles and numbers. And the only visit from my parents in those days that I was there was when they came and they brought me puzzles. And I sat in that cage and I solved them 1, 2, 3. And that's what the brain is prepared for, the fragmentation, is they took me out of the cage and wheeled me down a hall. There was another child brought out of the room, and I was brought into the room by what I always, even at that age, I thought they were very humanoid looking, a male and female. And they put me on the table, and they didn't put anything for lead or if they were x-raying. And they stepped out of the room and looked through a triangle in the wall and put their heads together and said, smile, and zapped me. And through learning about the program, they very well could have attached an entity to me right then.
This dream I had on October 1st, 2011, the gift of Yahushua giving me prophetic dreams has really been stirred up. And I'd like to say it's happy time, you know, but I have to give the dreams the way that they are because they are warnings. A prophet warns. So here goes. If you're paying attention to the dreams, and they're all going to be in videos eventually, God is truly warning. He's not warning to scare, so you'll be told in advance and you'll be able to make the right decisions. The spirit of insanity has been loosed in this world. If anyone doubts it, just open up a newspaper. There's no part of this world that isn't being, where you'll look at the things the government's doing, the people's doing, and laws being passed and shaking their fist at God. It's insane. It's all just insane right now. How they can think that a precious, innocent little baby in a mother's womb who's supposed to be safe is nothing more than disposable garbage to ripped and torn in shreds and thrown in a garbage can. Same-sex marriage, a mockery of Adam and Eve, and they pass laws. And they pass laws saying these things are legal. Homosexuality being taught to preschoolers. I shake my head. If that isn't insanity, what is? Feeding it to them on a silver spoon, saying, don't worry about it. Little girls, if you play with trucks, and little boys, if you play with dolls. We got a Chaz Bono here. He had his breast cut off, but he still has a vagina. But legally, you see, he's gone through these medical treatments, and so take shots of testosterone to look like a male, and so therefore, you know, he's got the beard on his face, and we could now call him a man, even though he was on his birth certificate. He was female and the cutest little girl you ever saw. But you're a homophobe, you know. You don't believe in transgenders, and if you don't believe that he can go and teach those little kids, and it's not a she, she's still a he, excuse me, even I'm mixed up, that they too can be a he, she. There should be, that's what should be on that birth certificate. Okay, if you want to do your transgender thing and get a new birth certificate, then put a he-she or she-he. But stop confusing us. No one is Cher is confused, but she has to act like it's okay because that's a child. The spirit of insanity has been loosed on this world, where evil is called good and good is called evil. Killers, can start. I mean, it's insane. I mean, you see these little kids killing each other. They're killing their parents. Their spirit of insanity has been loosed. And in my dream, I know one way. There's been an experiment going on. It's going to get far worse. It was like I was seeing inside of a mental hospital in my dream. I was watching this. And as the patients slept, men and women, there was a noise that came on over the internet. And oh, I'm sorry, not internet. Forgive me for that. I meant to say intercom. Gosh, I hope it's not internet. Who knows? But there was a noise that came on the intercom. Maybe used on the internet. I don't know. But it was just a small noise. Just a small noise that would trigger a mind control, mind programming to go in a certain patient. And when they woke up in my dream, I saw that they had been turned into killers. I saw them walking down the hall, and they just looked like normal patients, you know, dressed in street clothes. And then all of a sudden, they had a knife. And to the other patients that were not under this control, I mean, you have to have some test patients, I guess, the doctors thought, they would kill them, and they started stabbing them. Now, I realize dreams are symbolic, so I'm not saying that in these mental hospitals that they're actually allowing patients with knives to go and stab people, but I am saying there is something that has happened, evidently, where drugs have been given, or hypnosis, some form of mind control, and they have literally been making killers out of men and women, and it's going to get worse. Then what happened was the doctors let the patients out, and these same killers, who were supposed to be serial killers, by the way, they wouldn't just kill one time, and they would kill without a conscience, and they had to look completely normal. And I saw that. I saw the hospital open the door, and all of these were free to walk around this large city, and they just looked like normal people until a certain sound, sign, whatever it is, however they program their minds, something would happen. Whether it was a ringing of a telephone, I don't know what it is. But all of a sudden, in particular, this woman was walking across the street. She looked totally normal, an attractive woman, and then a car was waiting at a light. The window was rolled down, and I'm watching this as a spectator. And this woman was at the wheel was very pregnant. And this woman just, she thought that the woman crossing the street was walking towards the car, like to go past it. But instead, the window was open. She had this huge butcher knife. She just reached her arm in, and she just stabbed the woman in the stomach. The woman didn't have a chance in the car. So basically, my dream is a warning about mental hospitals. Be very careful. Be very careful of hospitals. Be careful of that which they call a mental hospital. Be careful of surgeries where they put tracking devices in you and chips. This world is insane. And only if you are truly born again, Holy Spirit filled, walking in obedience to Yahushua, washed in the shed blood of Yahushua HaMashiach, are you going to be spared from that spirit of insanity? Pray against it. Pray that you and your family will be protected from the spirit of insanity. I don't know what they're doing. I don't know if they're putting it in the food, in the water, in the air, like they do diseases. I'm just telling you, if you're not washed in the shed blood of Yahushua, and if you're truly not born again and Holy Spirit filled, and I don't mean with head knowledge, you better have it in your heart. You better totally be sold out 1,000%. Mind, body, spirit, and soul, and have no doubt that you belong to Yahushua HaMashiach, also called Jesus Christ in King James Version Bible. Oh, that spirit of insanity will come upon you. I notice a pattern, though. Those that are attacking me, attacking a Mighty Wind ministry, they're insane. And they're going more and more and more insane. They will actually take my words that I type as if I'm the most famous person in the world or something, and they put it in their videos. It's insanity. They are so obsessed with me. Who am I? Why? Insanity. And one of the curses of Deuteronomy 28 is insanity. And you know what? God allowed that spirit of insanity to come upon Saul. And only playing the harp could David even soothe him. But he allowed it. A spirit of insanity to torment King Saul. So that's my dream. That's my warning. Serial killers are being made. Okay? Is it so the gun laws will be taking away in America? I don't know. I really don't know. I know experimentation is going on. People, this is serious. The spirit of insanity has been loosed on this world. I don't know. I don't know what's happened. be careful of the medication given to you. Be careful, be careful, be careful. Pray over it that it has no side effects. I'm not saying stop your medication. Please don't do that. For doctors also are a blessing. Some doctors can be a blessing. Luke was a physician. All I'm saying is what the prophecies have spoken. The spirit of insanity has been loosed on this world. And serial killers are being made. And mind control, mind manipulation, some trigger, I'm telling you, I saw it, is being done when they're sleeping. And they don't only have to be in a mental hospital. I keep hearing a ringing of a phone even. It could be something so trivial. Something is happening that somebody calls, somebody gives a secret word, and it triggers that person. Come, Yahushua, come. Have mercy. Have mercy on all whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Oh, Abba Yahweh, in the name of Yahushua, slay these reprobates. Please protect your sheep and lambs. Please. If I care so much, how much more do you care, Yahushua? For you are the only good shepherd, the only Messiah. Protect all who listen and who believe the words that I have spoken and who are walking holy before you, who consider this message a blessing and me a blessing and not a curse. Protect them from the spirit of insanity. Protect their loved ones. Protect their family. Protect their homes. Protect them from the spirit of insanity. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, we stand in the scripture, for God did not give us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. And we claim it right here. In Yahushua HaMashiach's name, amen.
So many doubts try.